traditionally, the entire geospatial community was used to the era of putting pictures up in front of their monitor and looking at objects and making sense of what they see. Imagine if you could go from looking at pictures on a display screen to just having insights delivered in a tabular format to hundreds of thousands of customers.
One of the challenges we have in public health is that it's very difficult to get full fine-grained detail about health of populations. With Earth AI, we can actually start to understand which communities are vulnerable and then how to target interventions at those communities.
That's the promise of Earth AI. Time to market has been cut down significantly. So what took years to get to now can potentially be done in months.
What would usually take you weeks of processing, you can really do that in a matter of hours.
That's just game-changing value.
What's really fundamental about Earth AI is that it's for the first time bringing together a whole universe of data sets that allows us to make decisions in a new way.
With Google's Earth AI, you can start to now solve multidimensional problems.
With Earth AI, now we're able to identify exactly communities or villages that are going to be affected by hazards such as floods or droughts.
You can actually see what the forecast level of the river will be in the next couple of days.
Hurricanes will always happen, floods will always happen. The key is understanding beforehand what might happen.
It's constant because you get the updates every few hours.
We really can think about a different future and a different world for us. And Earth AI does arm us with the potential to design this future and deliver it.
It changes the game. You have the ability to now work at 10x the speed, 100x the speed. It gives you insights at a scale and at a resolution that we just didn't have before.
And the fact that Google is now bringing this to the world and to businesses to make decisions on and build products on, it's just really groundbreaking and extremely exciting.